Oh man, what's going on? What's going on? What's going on, everyone? Man, this one's gonna be a good one. I'm excited. This one, we've been trying to plan this for a while, and the trash talking back and forwards. I think everyone in the group chat knows what's going on, but you lot are gonna see what's going on today. But I have two guests that's gonna be here to commentate. Oh, I'm gonna be in the back, just watching this with my popcorn and getting some juice as well. It's going to be a little one, man. All right, we're going to take it to the commentators. It's going to be Hollow and we have Zero. So let's get into it, man. What's going on, guys? What's going on? What's going on?
Yes, it's good. I have been waiting for this match for a very long time. I think this is the perfect... These are the perfect Soul Calibur players to be going up against each other. I think you're going to get maximum entertainment today.
Absolutely. We've got one player who... plays a multitude of characters, you know, quite methodically and quite calculates how he does. And then the other one plays like an absolute rat.
All right, let's introduce them, man.
All right, so we got Kaz, aka Talon. I think Kaz is quite famous for winning that Dodge Nitro in the Wembley Arena back in 2007. I believe today he's going to be playing Cassandra. And yep. I think... people know him to not press buttons on him, basically.
and we've got Joel, you know, the one who's been playing Cervantes for since Soul Calibur 5 times, you know, doing quite well with him, and has done quite well during the last elf tournament, placing third place. You know, it's quite an achievement, especially with how stacked it was. Players like Holy Carp, Dexus, Neon in there as well. And today, however, is going to be playing Astroth, which is very, very interesting. Very interesting for Joel. Not the kind of character he'd normally play. But, you know, Astroth on a good day, he hurts. He hurts. You know, you guess wrong, you're dead.
Yep.
Astroth on a bad day, however, what do you do?
All right, let's get into it. Let's hear the lads. What's going on, man?
Yeah, all good, man. All good, man. I thought I'd teach Joel a lesson, you know. You got to teach the young'uns not to disrespect legends like myself, you know. So
I need a younger than you.
So let's see what happens. I mean, you've already learned in the past, you can't just change character and beat me. So choose a natural.
I can pick random select and fucking beat you, mate.
Okay, well, let's see.
All right, let's get into it, man. Let's get into it. So...
I just want to say for the record, this first attempt is beneath me, but just for the lols, I thought I'd take part.
Cool. You lot ready up? Let's get into it, man. Commentators, let's get into it.
Alright, so we'll be taking it from here on out. Thank you very much, King Jay.
Thank you.
And you know, as we say before, Silent Joel will be going with Astaroth. Kaz will be going up with Cassandra.
Who's your money on? Personally, if you were to pick a winner here, this is an endurance match, basically. Who do you think is going to take it?
My money's on Joel. My money's on Joel.
Okay. I'll take you up on that. My money's on Talon. I think he might actually pull it out of the bag.
I mean, it's not that I don't believe in Kaz, especially because, as you see right now, right off the bat, he's so aggressive. But you know, when you get down that kind of playstyle, it's quite easy to counter.
It is, but I think Joel is one of those players that spends a lot of time in training mode. He really learns the ins and outs of the game. And I think someone like Talon, where he sort of just plays off feeling, plays off heart, there's really no discouraging him, no matter how much he will press a button, even if he is minus 14.
And as you just said right now, starting off strong, winning the first round quite convincingly.
Yeah. So what do you think of this matchup?
I think this matchup's quite harsh for Astaroth, because you know his armor works differently than everyone else's. Nightmare, you trigger the armor, you get an AGI. With Geralt, Gwen, this will just blow through everything. Astaroth's armor, however, will take one hit, but if it takes a second hit, it just vanishes.
Well, it looks like there's absolutely no fear from either player right now. Talon seems to be out one round, and he's pushing the advantage.
Absolutely, and you know, as you just said again, Talon has absolutely no fear in his eyes, just taking it all the way, especially with a very strong second round as well.
But we have to stress that this is character lock, so if someone figures you out and you don't have a plan B, you're kind of stuck at that point.
And this is where I think Kaz is going to lose, because like once you get down his pattern, he's gone. Like he very rarely adapts. And what he does, he'll do it like 2 or 3 times, and then he'll go back to what he knows, and that's just mashing Cassandra.
Do you think there may be a rabbit hole to how crazy Kaz will play? Or do you think
there is no depth that he will not sink? If he's minus 14, he will press.
Well, Joe's on the scoreboard now. He's got one round in there, so he wasn't out. I thought he was out of the fight just now, but he's going for it.
Nah, you can never count Jola. And ooh, good throw break from Kaz. And the one thing that you notice with Joel that that Kaz will almost never do is actually play the neutral.
I don't think Talon knows what neutral is.
He doesn't know what neutral is. He doesn't know what neutral frames are. He doesn't even know what neutral is on the litmus paper.
He's gonna have to do something here though, because he's now got a red, I guess his shield is red, and it's quite easy for Astolf to break shields.
It really is. Red guard, and Joel is also locked and stocked with 2 bars, spending it now, and Astolf's soul charge is absolutely terrifying. The Poseidon Tide, which is +8 on block, and you cannot step this.
Talon's going for it. He
uses the Beyblade and taunts. So exactly what I mentioned before about Astolf's armor, even with a very strong tool such as Bull Rush, right? Yeah. In Soul Charge, this has armor. But Kaz knew that he was going to do this and readied up the Beyblade because it's a multi-hitting string and blew through Astolf's armor going for the ring out.
This is the thing that I think is going to give Talon the advantage. He plays in such an unpredictable way. I think the conventional player would have stood there and taken the hit, or would have been too fearful to move against Astolf, as you see a lot of the time. But there is no fear in Talon, so I think Joel's going to have to take that on board and really try to change up his approach a couple of times in this set.
Absolutely, absolutely right. But you know what? There's still several games to go. It is 5-10, and that is plenty of time for any player to get the download on their opponent. And Joel has been seen to do this many a time.
Now, why do you think Joel decided to go with Astolf today? Because people know him as a Cervantes or a Siegfried player. I didn't personally know he played Astolf. Oh, Joel is really going for it. I think Zero has frozen there, so we'll have to move along without him for the time being. But once again, Cassandra's up on the scorecards. Talon is really pushing the advantage. I don't really know the matchup. Zero is the one that really understands the ins and outs of this game. But based on their playstyles, from what I understand, Kaz or Talon is someone that doesn't think at all, and Joel is someone that thinks too much. And I really don't know how that's going to end up playing out here. My money is on Talon, as I said, but there's just no fear. Again, he's up on the scorecard, and Joel's really got to make an adjustment here because he's just getting pressured. Doesn't seem to have an answer, and again, like we said, Talon is just pushing buttons. He just won't stop pushing buttons, and I don't think Joel is really used to playing players like this. This is just a relentless beating. He's popped the soul charge, going for it. He's one hit away now. Nice step. Nice chunk of damage. With a good soul charge. And that is 2-0. It's not looking good for Joel right now, but there's a lot of time left. I wouldn't count him out just yet. But Talon, a very good start.
That is crazy. Yeah, we're just filling in for Zero. I think his camera just froze, or his Discord froze, so I'm going to fill in for him quickly. It's 2-0 right now.
What do you make of this?
Obviously, I don't really want to say too much, but we were serving a 10-0, and right now it's kind of gone. It's looking like the reverse, and I'm not really a Soul Calibur guy like that. Like, I like to watch it. I think it's very entertaining. But yeah, Watching this now, I'm like, yo, this is looking it's looking a bit one-sided. But it is a 5-10, so he can come back. So we'll see.
I don't personally know what the matchup here is, but from what I can see, it looks like it might be in Cassandra's favor. I could be wrong, but this just looks very, very one-sided right now. And unfortunately, Joel is locked in for the duration of this set.
Yeah, it's character lock, right?
It is character lock, yeah, so he's going to have to make some sort of adjustment here.
from when I used to play this game, I remember Ashraf being quite slow. So like Cassandra and Sofitia, those characters usually like was quite good against Ashraf. Yeah. I don't know if that's the same thing now.
Yeah, I'm not too sure about how this matchup plays out. I know Ashraf has historically struggled with characters that are quite nimble.
Yeah.
From what I remember from previous Soul Calibers anyway, but this is looking... Oh, he's fighting back here. Pushing the advantage, he could get the ring out.
Ooh. Yeah, now he's fighting back. Damn.
He just won't stop pressing buttons. There's absolutely no fit.
Oh, man. He just got... Oh, that was nice. That was nice. He's nice. Joel's fighting back.
Joel's going to have to do something here because he will not hear the end of it if Talon pulls this off. Okay, Joel's up. But again, there's just no fear in Talon. Nice step.
Nice throw break. To change sides. Oh, nice throw break again. Nice. Oh, I'm just seeing buttons galore.
He's just pressing buttons, bro. I think he needs to go play Horan or something.
Oh, that was a nice reversal edge. Ooh, dead. Yeah.
Round, yep.
Ooh. Oh, Torn, okay. Is this what's going on?
He's coming back. How will Talon respond to this onslaught? Oh, wow. That Beyblade move looks crazy oppressive.
Yeah. Right, Soul Charge popped. Whoa. Oh. I was expecting a big combo from that, man.
He's figured him out. I think he's figured him out.
It might be over.
Something happened. Oh, he steps right into it. That's 2-1. So Joel is showing signs of life. Fortunately.
It is a thing of it is a first to 10. And, you know, historically, first to 10, anything can go. So he could be figured out. It could be figured out. Or it could be the case of it might have been a lucky win. We don't know yet. We don't know.
Yeah, I mean, Zero's prediction was that Talon was going to start very offensive and he'd be figured out quite quickly and then it would sort of be a landslide. And hopefully we don't see that here. Hopefully we see some adaptation. Because this isn't a tournament. He won't get away of just winning 2 games and moving on. You know, he's going to have to show some competency in an endurance match.
Yeah. Oh, nice.
Very nice. He's just being rushed down now. He doesn't seem to have an answer. We're looking at a perfect... Oh, okay.
Can he come back from this?
I think he can do it. He's doing it. Oh.
Nice. He's coming back. Oh, no way.
He's coming back.
Oh. Oh, I was about to say, he's going to come back all this way. Okay.
Talon's got to do something because Joel is gaining in confidence and that's the last thing he really wants right now. And, man, I thought he was going to get the ring out there.
Yeah.
Going oh, nice. For it.
Nice.
Oh.
Oh.
Are we going to see a ring out?
Nice break attack. Ooh,
oh,
death.
Nice. That's it. Oh, no, he's alive.
This is looking rough, man.
The pendulum is starting to swing.
I just want to let you lot know in the stream chat as well. You lot are going to see a halfway through intro. So it's going to be like in the middle. I don't know whereabouts we're going to place it, but there's going to be an interview with both of the players to find out what's going on. And that's where the trash talk is going to be fun.
Yeah.
So you lot don't want to miss out on that in action. I'm telling you, this has been... a long time no works, and I'm just excited that we got this happening.
Yeah, do you know what? The WhatsApp group has basically been alive with trash talk between these two. So it's going to be... The loser's really going to have to take the L on the chin. Oh, nice. Looking for the ring out.
Ooh, nice. Dead? No?
Oh! Down to the wire.
Wow.
Nice! So he will not go gently into the night. Talon is fighting back here. How will Joel answer in this round? He doesn't have any meter, so that is something to look out for.
Ooh, okay, reversal edge. Where are you gonna, what's it gonna do? Ooh! Astral one.
Ooh, oh.
About to
does
say.
Does that ring up?
Yeah, it does.
Oh, nice. Oh, stop.
No. Nice.
Okay.
You know what? I don't think we're giving Massaf enough credit, you know. Everyone thinks he's just mashing.
The gears are turning. There is something upstairs. Nice, that could have been a ring out.
Wow. Pop the soul charge.
Oh, no throw break.
Oh, I've never seen that before.
I've never seen that either, but then I've been out of the game for a while, so he's coming back with these throws, man.
Yeah. You know, when I played Astro, it sounds like the guy saying break a fart. Oh, no. Oh, no.
Very, very, very nice super. Really cool to get this great part or something. That was ugly.
Man said, good, you're quiet now, you know. Astro is relentless.
2-2, so we're off to a pretty explosive start. Hopefully Talon has some sort of answer for what just happened. I know it's quite soul-crushing to have someone do a super move in your face and basically negate all of your pressure, but hopefully he's got an answer for this.
This is crazy, man. Like, you know, it was such a good start for Massaf, and it's like, now I'm looking, I'm like, I don't know now, it's quite neck and neck.
I think the pendulum is going to continue to swing back and forth during this set. I think it's going to come down to the wire. Because Talon did show signs of life in that last match. He unfortunately got caught with a string of grabs and then obviously the super move at the end. But he's playing back here. Oh, that was nasty. This is a smaller stage as well, I think, so the opportunity for ring outs is definitely there.
You know, watching this game makes me actually want to play it, you know? Like,
definitely.
It's just so hype. Like, I used to, like, when I first got the game, I played it quite a bit and then I stopped playing it. But then watching this grudge match and the trash talk, I'm like, bruh, I actually want to play this. This actually looks cool.
Yeah, this is looking very one-sided right now. Joel just completely dominated that round. He's made me rethink this matchup. You know, I didn't really know much about it before, but it's looking very one-sided right now.
Same. I'm definitely, because I thought that the faster characters just give Ashraf hell, but now it's not looking like that at all.
Yeah, I think Zero might be able to shed some more light on how this matchup plays out.
Thank you, Paulo. Very sincerest apologies, everyone. Brother knocked out my land cable.
No worries.
The problems of living with family.
Yeah. So I see Joel's gone up too.
Yep.
Yeah. He's pushing the advantage now. But we wanted to know really, like, how does this matchup play out in your opinion? Which character sort of takes the advantage?
Okay, so it's quite weird because Astroth can play at range. Because, you know, he's got like a massive axe and he can play the long range and the mid range pretty well. But he's a grapple character, so he wants to get in close, right? The only problem with that is that Cassandra is also doubly dangerous up close.
Yeah.
But very, very good 2-2-B from Joel.
Yeah, I'm not gonna lie, this is looking kinda bad. We still got the interview coming halfway through the set, so I really want to know what these men are. I want to know what they're going to say, because you lot have not been in the group chat, so you lot don't understand the levels of trash talk between these two.
The flames, man. People are getting called out left, right, and center.
Like, oh, man. All right, cool. So, you know, Zero's going to take over. Obviously, it's going to be, you know, them two commentating. I'm going to be in the back, but yeah, I might be the third wheeler on the commentary, because this is just too hype.
Thank you so much, DJ. And once again, apologies for bailing unexpectedly.
Cool, good. But I was really pushing the advantage here, man. He's what you predicted, it seems to be coming true. He's figured out how Talon's playing and he's just rushing him down.
Absolutely. I mean, as we say, like, in first to two settings and you know, even possible first to three settings, you know, in like winners finals or like in pools, right? If you catch your opponent off guard with this super hyper aggressive play, and your opponent doesn't have much time to figure it out, right? Then you can just kind of leave him in the dust. Yeah. But when you try this in like in a first to ten setting where there is plenty of time to get your opponent on the download, catching on to their timings, you know, what button are they gonna press against yours? What spacing are they gonna do anything? you can kind of get that into your mind, and just like you can form any kind of counterplay you want. And Joel, as you say, is doing this surprisingly well, and with Astra of all characters.
Yeah, I guess like I think this is like the age-old argument of fighting games, where you have tournament, you people enter tournaments, and it's first of three or best of three or first of five, and you don't really get to see how players will adapt to fighting styles. And I guess here you get to really see who knows their character the best, who knows the opponent's character well, and who understands how to navigate. Basically, like
ring out.
Oh no!
But yes. But yes, Harlow, absolutely true. When playing in a 33 setting, it's kind of like, how fast can you adapt to the character? In a 1-10 setting or 1-5 setting, it's how fast can you adapt to the opponent?
Yeah, definitely. I think there's certain characters, Cassandra might be one of those characters, but they're just very overwhelming to try and learn about very quickly. I know that when I was playing this game, I was well aware of how overwhelming Azwel was at the beginning of this game's lifespan.
Absolutely. So
in tournament, I was aware there were certain players that I would beat that were better than me, but I knew that they just weren't going to be able to adapt in time to you know, take over. And I think that's what we're seeing here. Initially, Talon really like rushed Joel down. He didn't seem to have an answer. And if that was tournament, Talon might have advanced.
Absolutely.
But I was showing here that he's quite knowledgeable, and he adapts. He's showing that he's able to adapt, which is really important.
I mean, it's like one of the things that you probably noticed in like in each situation is that whenever Kaz does one A, he'll always follow it up with a full crouch 3A from Cassandra. This is a true bona fide step killer, and it nets a Divine Force, which is like kind of Nightmare's Terror Charge, right? So she gains access to Divine Force moves, and when they hit, my god, do they hurt!
Yeah, this, I mean, when she's rushing you down, this looks painful. It looks extremely annoying to deal with, so that's a testament to how good of a player Joel is, because he, even at the brink of losing, he's quite composed, he's not rushing in.
Oh, and gets caught off guard by the Captain America throw.
Bro, what is that Beyblade move?
That's his Cassandra's shield throw, right? So it counts as a projectile, and just like Captain America, it bounces back towards her. And people get caught off guard by the second hit because it has a very deceptive hitbox.
That is cheap.
Could you just, at what point did Cassandra gain the ability to shoot Force Lightning? Like, when did that ever happen in Soul Calibur?
Soul Calibur 6, it's the same game where everyone decided that, you know, we're gonna make projectiles a thing. But never mind that, Kaz is going for a swim.
Oh my goodness, this is too hype.
We're sitting at 4-2 right now, ain't we?
Yeah.
Okay, so Kaz has really got to do something here.
He still has the 2-round lead, and is close to building up a bar of meter. And Cassandra, when she has bar, is disgusting. We've seen the length and the range of that Beyblade, and you know, at the end, it's a break attack, so you can't even RI this. You can't even reverse ledge this.
So does that Beyblade, that Captain America shield, does it take no meter? She can just sort of throw it out there.
She can just throw it out there. I mean, it does come with the downside that it costs 10% guard gauge. Like, when you notice Cassandra doing certain moves, as you saw right there's that very small purple flash. This costs her guard gauge.
Right. Oh god.
Oh, but no, it's going with a second hit!
Oh man. So it's 4-3 now. It's quite competitive. It's going back and forth.
Absolutely. And I think we've hit the halfway mark.
Do you want to do it when someone hits 5, and then we'll do the interview? We'll do it when someone hits 5.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, you're right. Sorry. I thought for a second that Joel hit 5.
Oh no. You're good.
So whoever loses this is really gonna have to just hold the L in the chat. They know they're gonna get roasted. And this is not the way you want to enter the Christmas season. So they're really gonna be trying to push the advantage here.
Dashing through the lows.
That is again, Talon rushes in. No fear.
Rushes in and does 1B, and you saw how Joel is immediately ready for it.
Yeah, he's adapted. I still think Joel was a little bit weary because Talon, he's just not stopping. He won't stop pressing buttons.
I mean, that's something that you have to consider, and that is that when you have an opponent that absolutely refuses to adapt, you just have to kind of like do your thing. You have to do your thing, and then you have to keep doing your thing. And that's what Joel is doing right now, and because he knows that Kaz will not, cannot stop. And predicts the low! Like, that low though is an absolute call-out, and goes for the Spinebuster!
So it was very, that was very, like, calculated and patient from Joel. After all that rush down, you know, his life was gone in the flash of an eye.
Absolutely, and you know, it's also like a giant testament to Joel's like his mental state, right? Because to be in that kind of position against someone like Cassandra and against Kaz, who will not stop pressing, to still have like the mental fortitude to stay there and still claim the clutch win.
So has Joel been consistent on this game, and he's still playing the game quite consistently?
He's been here and there, and as we mentioned, like in there was a really stacked tournament at East London Fighters, and he placed third.
Okay, what a talent.
Yeah, I mean, you know, coming out over players like Holy Carp, and you know, this is something that was unheard of back in the day, because Holy Carp was like one of the best players in the game. But you know, good whiff punish from Kaz, and this is gonna kill. Boom.
Okay, so if Kaz wins, oh, that was a perfect. If Kaz wins this, we'll be looking at a 4-4, and we'll be going into the final game before the break, just to get a few words from the players to see how they are mentally. You know, I imagine they have a lot to say to each other right now.
Just a quick one in the stream chat. Everyone that's watching the stream chat, you can predict your points on who is going to win. So if it's Masop, predict your points. If it's Silent Joel, predict your points as well.
And Kaz is going to want to get away from that edge. Joel's looking for the ring out.
Or does he? Because Cassandra actually has a reverse ring out. She does. 6-6 B plus K is... Oh, gets caught by the shield throw again. So it's like, you know, Cassandra is a character that is very... very dominant at the top range. But that is her one of her few mid-range control options.
Oh god, this is getting ugly.
Oh, there's not quite the ring out, but he's just changed the position! One wrong move!
And I wanna roll away.
Hephaestus, lend me your strength! Still staying strong. Pop soul charge!
Went down to the wire here.
Oh, that's guaranteed. Oh, no. What's the mix?
Oh no! You have to
leave
like a
pumpkin
boost
of
the job.
Oh no.
Alright. Lucky.
Alright, it's
a... There's three matches, you won fucking lucky, man. You got the little internet connection, what can I do?
Nah, man, don't even try.
At least upgrade to Tesco, man.
So are we hearing from the players now, yeah?
Yeah, well, we're already hearing from them, man.
Two matches, I was playing with my feet, and I thought, you know what, I'll use my hands. And then you got really lucky on that proper laggy one, and then, you know, it's alright, it's five straight from here. I know people got to eat their dinner and stuff, so.
Oh, man. So we're hearing the interview with the players, obviously. Zero Hollow. Interview the players, let me know what they are saying, man.
Alright, so Joel, you're playing Astaroth, you're playing what is quite possibly one of your terrible matchups. But you're playing against Kaz, so you know, in your mind you're thinking right now, you've got this in the bag. So tell me, how do you plan on continuing this momentum?
Basically, you just don't think. You just press buttons, because there's no point thinking, because you can't condition this guy, because he's just pressing buttons. He's sidestepping at advantage, you know what I mean? Like, just bring out the laglers, you know, there's no point in thinking, you know, just
I wanted to ask Kaz, you started off really, really strong. You know, you went up 2-0.
I was playing with my feet.
And you have come back. But I want to know, what are you going to do to adjust? Because it seems like Joel is adjusting to, you know, your constant rushdown.
He's not adjusting. What it is that Astaroth only has to hit you 2 or 3 times and it's game over, right? And he's got quite a good ring out game. He's plus on everything. So as you see, I mean, even though people are joking that I'm pressing buttons, I'm not really, if you see. And even Joel is doing madness when I'm on plus and he's pressing buttons for some strange reason. He always stepping when it's not his turn. So to be honest, I got his ticket. It's not a problem. Like the last two games have gone to the last round, last hit. You know, I'm gonna turn it around and make it more convincing, because the fact that he's won 5 already is a bit embarrassing. I know, but don't worry.
My ticket's going 1st to 10, mate. It's going 10. You're stopping off at 3. You know, you're already here.
Oh my gosh. All right, let's get back into it, man. We're going to get back into it. Commentators, let me know what you lot think as well, man.
I think, like I said before, Joel got this in the bag. You know, at the start, you know, Kaz is strong, but in the later games is when Joel understands what he has to do. And as you said before, sometimes against a player like this, you just don't think. You just do.
Yeah, I think Kaz is going to start like using some different tactics now. He can't push forward with what's been going on because Joel has been kind of been patient. He's taken a couple of hits here and there, and then we've seen sort of the same pattern each round for the last couple of games where he grabs him a few times and it's game over. He's not pushing too much, and so we're off to a good start.
I mean, it's kind of like how well Joel understands when he needs to extend and when he should stop overextending.
Yeah, exactly.
And this is kind of what kills Kaz a lot, and the fact that he will overextend.
I think he just gets a bit too confident sometimes. He needs to like slow it down, and then he'll be fine.
But you know, I'm liking Kaz's use of Cassandra's BK. This is like one of the. Great confirm off the wall splat.
But that was another prime example of Kaz needing to slow down a bit. He had the life lead and he didn't really need to push too hard there. He could have waited to see what Joel was going to do, but Joel hit him. Joel knew he was going to press buttons and he hit him with a reversal edge, and that was the game.
Mm-hmm. And there it is once again, 1A into full catch 3A.
He's getting rushed down right now in the corner, man.
As you say before, you know, Astroth against the wall is kind of like the last place you want to be, and this kind of puts you into the mind game where if you guess wrong on a throw, you're going to eat a lot of damage, so you want to back away, but doing so, you give Astroth more ground to work with.
Well, I mean, this approach isn't working right now. He's really being put to school. Mm-hmm. You know, all of his options are being shut down. He starts off very well each game, but Joel just seems to pull it back each time.
Absolutely. It's like, I'll give credit to Kaz on one thing, and that is that when he has to, he actually will make adaptations, but usually these come like really, really late in game if you've done something to him every time.
Yes.
Like right there, Astroth was plus 8, and Kaz decided to press a button.
Yeah, he definitely needs to calm down a bit here. I think he needs to, pick his moments a little bit better because Joel, and he taunts, man. He taunts in your face, bruv. Don't have it.
But gets the divine force for the troubles. Is he gonna get no blocks? Once again, Joel running away with this round.
Oh, 6-3.
No.
You can see that gap kind of widening now.
Yeah.
And this, normally with most players, I'd say the confidence of the person losing would have been shaken, but Kaz just seems to have no fear, so I'm sure he can still pull it back. It's everything to play for right now.
I mean, at this point, he might pull back like maybe one, maybe two more games, and this might be like the confidence boost he needs, like the momentum he needs to gain, right? And we're about to get Dark Caliber, aren't we?
Oh, I don't know what's happened.
Okay, for once, it's not me. Yep, Dark Caliber. It wouldn't be a Soul Caliber event if there wasn't at least one Dark Caliber.
What the hell is Dark Caliber?
Yeah, explain that to me.
All right, so when you see this screen, like what you're seeing right now,
yeah.
You see these three dots behind on the side of Joel and on the side of Kaz, yeah? And okay. You can see that one dot is lit up on the cash screen. This is what we refer to as Dark Caliber, because like at this point you're just guessing or what's happening right now.
Oh, so they're actually playing?
Yeah, they're playing. We just can't see.
And this is why
you need rollback.
Whoa!
How often does this happen? Is this something that's
very very often. It happens at least one major event online, at least once.
Yeah, no, that's bad. It's 1-1 so far, guys. I guess we're just commentating the lobby screen for now.
Yeah.
Whoa, I didn't know this happens on Soul Calibur. That's mad.
It happens fairly often, and you know, this is what happens when people refuse to have rollback in fighting games.
So this has been happening for a couple of seasons now.
Yeah.
So Namco is basically just, you know, they're like,
well, I mean after the last patch which removed Denuvo, that just killed us. We knew that that's the last one you're ever gonna get.
Serious?
Yeah.
What did they remove? Man. What did you say they removed?
Denuvo, which is like the anti-cheat thing, I think. Something along those lines.
Why would they remove an anti-cheat thing? That's like... I don't know. Why would you do that?
I mean, you know, when everyone downloaded that the latest patch, that was the patch. We're going to remove this thing. I mean, they say it's for better performance, but obviously this is peak performance.
That's disappointing. So do you not think we're going to get any more updates for this game, or is that it?
We did. So it means like one thing, and that's like in the future we're probably going to get Soul Calibur 7.
Oh wow! So that means the game is done. It's finished.
We're done. Yeah. So it's like the only thing that we can do now is to keep the scene going. You know, with the online first attends, online events, and offline events too.
That's crazy. That's crazy though, because you know what it is. I think somebody in the chat said they removed it for Tekken as well. So I think we're done for Tekken as well in terms of like new DLC and stuff.
Yeah.
Yeah, but Tekken needs to be done now, man. How many years has it been? Let's move on. Let's get Kiryu in Tekken 8, you know? Let's get some new characters in there. Bring Jinpachi back.
you know who I would love to be in Tekken? I'd love Majima to come into Tekken.
There's no way they could put Majima in over Kiryu. Like, I love Majima, but fan base would go ballistic.
I mean, if not Kiryu or Majima, then the new one, Kasuga Ichiban. I love this character.
He's
so fun.
Even right. Yagami would be good. I think Joel took that, didn't he?
Yeah, Joel just won another one, so that's 7-3.
7-3, and not only potentially three more to go.
This is crazy, man. This is, you know why it's crazy? You lot just see this as a first to 10. We see this in the WhatsApp group as bragging rights. So yeah,
absolutely.
It is going to be going on for weeks. I know I can see it. I was going to see my fingers popping up every single time of trash talk.
And is this one of the new stages from Samurai Shodown?
Absolutely. Haomaru stage, the Gairu Isle.
I thought that was such a good addition to the game.
It is. And you know, they've included all the little touches as well. Like when they announced the round start, it's the actual announcer from Samurai Showdown as well.
Oh, yeah, sick.
But Joe's running away with him, man. He's actually dominating Talon. It doesn't look like Talon's got an answer for this.
No. Like I say, when it's at this late in the game, Kaz will adapt. But at this point, Joel has his number, and he's going to absolutely run away with this.
Let's not count him out yet. He might pull something out of the bag, you know? I know it seems like a bit of a mountain to climb, but this game is very momentum-based, and the pendulum could swing quite easily.
It is, but you know, all the momentum in Joel's favor right now. I'm, like, against Astroth, against the wall, this is not where you want to... Good luck on the standing K.
They're making me miss this game.
Don't miss this game. Don't do it.
The last time we played was when we played Soul Calibur 5. Did a little bit of Albo versus Man.
You might remind me, I had a literal headache pain.
Joel's just dominating this now. It's potentially going to go up to 8-3.
Yeah. Oh. Immediately spends the Divine Force.
So can he only do that once per round?
No, it's whenever Cassandra does a move that gives a Divine Force, she can expend it the same way that Nightmare is allowed to expend Terror Charge.
Right. Okay. Is there a reason why she wouldn't use it, or do you always use it at the end?
I mean, it's quite difficult to maintain. There aren't very many moves that allow you to gain it in the first place, and there are very few situations that allow you to recycle Terror Charge as well.
Right. Okay.
Oh, Joel's gonna go! No, he's gonna go!
Very nice. Very nice mix up. He's waking up. I think he knows what's going to happen if he loses his first attempt, especially with beating like this. The group chat is not going to let him sleep. And you know what? It goes beyond the group chat because there's other group chats that are currently watching this. So he's going to have a mountain of people on his case if he doesn't bring something back.
This is the first case of the fucking bull rushes. Oh, I apologize. The bull rush catching sidesteps. This is something that's known since the dawn of time.
Okay, so Talon's looking to get his name on the board again.
But he's got to deal with Astroth at two bars, and we've seen how disgusting. Have we seen how disgusting his CE is?
We have. He's been caught by it a few times. I remember there was a round ending critical edge that he hit him with.
It hurts, doesn't it? It hurts.
It's a heartbreaker.
Oh, catches him stepping with the Beyblade! No, he drops the stomp!
Okay, there's an opportunity to come back here.
There is.
Smart.
I think two or three more decisions in Cass's favor, and he could actually pull this back. No, not like this, Cass!
Oh, you hate to see it.
Splat on the floor!
Man, 8-3, and Joe's not leaving. Welcome this to stage of history. There's not gonna be any doubt after this. There's gonna be no doubt at all.
The doubt would have been the three that Joe lost.
And you know, Joe played this very smart, because we know him as a Siegfried and Cervantes player. So not only did Joe protect himself by using Astaroth, because if he had lost, he could have turned around and said, well, I didn't use my main. But he has not only beaten Talon quite convincingly here, not yet, but he's beating him with a character that he doesn't consider his main.
Mm-hmm. But as we said before, you know, Joel will take to the lab and he will find out whatever's broken about the character, and he will ride it as far as he can. And we see it right now that he's just riding all of the long range hits, doing all as much damage as he can. Oh, good lethal from Kaz! Goes to our resetup! And the damage just from that is so disgusting.
And would you say having a stage with no ring outs favors Cassandra more than it does Astaroth?
I think for Cassandra, it favors her more if she has a stage that she could ring out on, because her wall combos aren't typically good. They only break like maybe 70, sometimes 80, but mostly they're usually 60. Astaroth on a wall goes upwards of 100.
Oh god.
And that's... And that is like typical of most characters in this game, where if you land a wall, you are eating 100 damage.
Yeah, Joel just looks like he's having fun now. He's just having his way with
he is.
Alan.
Good throw from Gaz. Goes for the unblockable. Catches him. Gets the divine force. That's not a real combo, Gaz.
Oh, this is getting ugly.
Now, both players trying to play neutral, but if there's one thing you don't want to do is play neutral against Joel, especially— Oh god, rip punish!
Nice! Very nice. That was a clutch critical edge.
Kaz proving he still has some fight left in him.
He has not put down the sword and shield yet. He could still very well bring this back.
It'd be a tall order, but you know, it's not impossible.
And if he does, you know Joel's not going to hear the end of that either. I'm going to make sure that neither of them, whoever loses him, are going to hear the end of this. They will be getting mean from morning till midnight.
Being crushed! Pop Soul Charge has to do something here and now if he wants to stay in the game.
How the fuck played. You guys said that? This is ugly. He has an answer for every option.
Oh, doesn't do well, full character 3A. Proof that Kaz can adapt when he needs to.
His guard is not great though. He's down on meter compared to us.
And this is kind of where Cassandra isn't so strong, because you know, her better moves, as we've seen, cause it like guard damage, right? And Astaroth is a character that does copious amounts of guard damage.
Yep. He's got him at the wall. Nice
guard. Gets him with the 1KB.
There's still just no fear from Talon. Could take this one. Oh,
it's down to the wire. Who's gonna win this round? Oh,
the chip.
Plus eight. Oh no, we get him.
Oh no.
Well planned arm strike.
This is looking mad.
This is deep, the flame of Talon was extinguished very early in the set.
The problem is, he's just too shit.
You hate to see it.
I can't do myself so low.
And Zero is just eating this up.
If you could hear them in chat, in voice chat right now, you'd understand why.
Oh, I can't even hear them. I didn't want to get involved in their banter.
It's amazing.
Can the stream hear them?
I don't think they can. Oh, get them with the fully charged break attack.
Oh, so. Hold on, man, sick guys.
Does that DK Titan bomb?
This is ugly.
Oh, good punish on the Angel Step AD as well.
Sorry to the people that was on stream. I had it on commentator just because I was trying to say passive, man. I was trying to say mass off. I didn't want you lot to see the 10-3. Hopefully it was not 10-3. I want him to prove me wrong in it, but...
Yeah, well, I mean, I'm rooting for Kaz. Kaz is my boy. You know, I've played against him for a long time. I'm rooting for Talon, but if I'm being 100% objective, this is looking extremely one-sided right now.
Absolutely. Yeah. As we've seen, all the momentum is on Joel's side, and he's just popped.
And Joel just seems to be having fun with this now. He doesn't seem to be... I mean, he's got room to mess about now. He doesn't really have to put too much. He can kind of fiddle around with the moves you don't usually see from Astaroth.
And he's doing, and he was doing quite a very good job at keeping Kaz at bay with the keep out moves. He gets a bear hug. Oh, good break on the throw.
This does give Kaz the opportunity to become a legend. You know, if he pulls this back now on the brink of defeat.
But as we say, Kaz now on match. Kaz? No, I mean sorry, Joel now on match point, and locked and stocked with 2 bars a meter.
And you know that Kaz is going to want to avenge himself. You know he's going to be in the lab after this. Because there's no way that you can take a beating of this magnitude and just call it a day.
Now, see, Kaz and lab are two words that are never in the same sentence.
I hope you lot in the Twitch chat. I hope you lot's channel points are okay, man.
Oh, good duck.
Oh my goodness. Oh no!
The game's over! The game's over!
Oh,
absolutely, you know what I mean? No doubt. He is decimated.
No!
No!
Wait, guys. Let's do this the right way. Hold on. Commentators, first and foremost, because these lot want to get at each other straight away. What do you lot think about it? Joe, wait a second. Commentators, please, what do you not think about that first attempt?
Do you want to go first?
Yeah, sure. So basically, it is exactly as I described. Kaz starts off strong at the beginning, but you know, a star that burns twice as bright burns half as long.
Well, I guess Zero called it. You know, Kaz is one of those like very, very dangerous tournament players where he has such an oppressive style of playing that when you go up against him, you can more than likely just not know what hit you. But unfortunately, as Joel said, you know, in an endurance match, he figured him out very quickly, and you know, that was all he wrote, unfortunately.
All right, so this time around, we're not going to make one person speak and another person speak in terms of the players. We're just going to make both of them go at it. All right, guys.
First of all, let me say this one thing, right? Every game, except for the last game, was the last round, yeah? Let's take
I
that
I can't make
first
it entertaining, man. I want to keep it. That's why there's a point.
And I know you got a towel there and you must be sweating, bro, because you Ashgoth is actually so shit, I couldn't adjust my level one thing. In time.
Because I don't need to say it, just look at the score, that's it, you know what I'm saying?
Oh my dude, that's right. It's all good, man. It's all good because I'm coming back for you, man. Definitely.
Nah,
is not good.
I know it's one of the worst characters. You know, it makes it a little bit entertaining.
You know, guys, can I just need to pick
another team? Are you joking? When we're gonna use Siegfried and Azurvi versus this?
Well, because I've already smacked them already. Are you forgetting the last time we played First Survive?
I have witnesses, but at least
is a record, public record, you know? Richie, we was at what's that bar place where we played pay to play and we did the first 5 days. Siegfried got smoked, bro. Then he bought Sabonis, he got smoked, and then he won another one of Siegfried, so it was 2-1. Obviously, I was using Mina, so obviously that's a bit different, isn't it?
Yeah, you should have brought Mina, at least it would have been at least something. Like your Cassandra's dog shit, but your mean is shit. Ooh. So it's really nice.
All right, you know what? Yeah, I'm hearing this talk. Do both players? Do you not have to go? Or does anyone have? Do they have to go?
I've got to go in like 10 minutes.
In 10 minutes, do you want to do maybe like a first to three with your
with what?
So I'd say Joel, you play Siegfried, right? Or Cervantes, and obviously you play.
I haven't played him for a couple of months, really, but I'll play.
You've already won the first attempt, to be fair. But like, you know, if you lot wanna, because we're talking, I'm hearing other characters, so I'm thinking if we're hearing other characters, then let's do like a first to three quickly.
Okay. I'm on it.
Okay.
Well, who do you want me to use?
Anyone you want me? I have no.
Wait, you're just moaning about characters and stuff. So choose.
I'm not saying you to Astral if you want. It's fine.
I don't care.
can we request that you use Cervantes?
Okay, I'm playing on pad. Usually I play on hitbox, but I'll play on pad.
What about Siegfried? Can you play Siegfried on pad?
Nah. I can't do AGA on pad.
I'm
not used to it. I don't need AGA, to be honest.
If you use Cervantes, it's not even going to be worth using Mina. If you use Cervantes, I'll just use Cassandra because my Mina is not even worth it, innit? If you're going to use Astroph, I'll use Sung Mina. If you use Cervantes, I'll just smack you with Cassandra.
You guys can pick who I pick and stuff. I'll go with it. I don't mind.
All right. So you know what? You've been really well with Astroph. You could still play Astroph. To be honest, I would really like to see your Siegfried because. I know you. I've seen you play Siegfried a lot before.
Okay, one sec. Let me have to switch to hitbox in one sec.
All right, wicked. All right.
It's working. Last time it was broken.
What were you saying, Hollow? Who did you want to see?
He just proved that his Astroph was quite a lot to deal with, and I think it would be quite good to see how
another character
Mina against his Astroph, because if he beats him 3-0, maybe there's an opportunity for a 10 first to 10 run back.
You know what? That is a good point. But you know what? What happens if Kaz doesn't win again?
Then we've got a perfect legend Sonic Fox situation.
Yes, I was about to say this.
Nah, there's no whitewashing here though, bro. Let's get it.
Perfect connection and stuff. Yeah, no problem.
Gonna have to rename him. Gonna have to rename him to 13 talent.
Yeah.
Wait, who am I using then?
I would like to see Astroph take on Mina to see how Kaz fares against that, because then maybe we have an argument for a run back.
True. And then obviously, if not, then that means this whole segment is put to bed, that you could play Astroph and beat him with both characters.
Yeah.
I'll use Astro again, yeah?
Yeah.
Send me an invite.
All right, cool. You said you an invite. All right, channel points again, everyone. You know, I know I'm sorry for the people that lost their points, and I'm...
What the hell, man? These guys are betting on Kaz. Oh, they don't know, innit? So I don't know. Now they know, innit? So you can make the money.
I'm gonna.
it'll be absolutely hilarious now if everyone bets on.
Oh man, hey, this has been. You know the worst thing is that. I knew this was going to be hyper fun to watch, but I didn't know it was going to be this fun. We need to do another one again, because this is hilarious.
Yeah, I think we need to get Soul Calibur grudge matches going on the regulars. I think Zero, maybe you should take on someone next.
I don't play this game anymore. I'm just a humble commentator now.
All right, cool. Let's set it again. So we're going to do... Okay, cool. Right, we're ready. First to three, everyone. Obviously, channel points, guy to rush in the chat. Could you set the channel points so that everyone can choose? Hopefully, good luck to both players. I'm looking forward to this, man.
So, Mina versus Astroph. This is something that I don't think goes well for Astroph either, because she does exceptionally well up close with the Hell Sweeps, as you just see. And here comes the Vortex!
The Song Mina is just like, she just completely confuses me every time.
Yeah, bro. Yeah, she's a Mishima character with Hell Sweeps.
Yeah, essentially. Well, I mean, it's a first to three, but Joel's had time to adjust to, you know, Kaz's general craziness, so we'll see how it plays out here. But if Kaz is able to clean sweep this set, then we're definitely going to have another first to 10 run back, Song Mina versus Astro.
Mina, one of those characters that also does, as you've just seen, does well at the far range as well. But also, for some reason, has almost every tool available, like every mechanic in the game. If you need an AGI, she has one. If you need a command grab, she has one.
So she essentially has an answer for every situation.
Absolutely. And as you saw right there, that AGI parries vertical attacks, and it gives it like a full confirm.
Oh my goodness.
Crazy.
Nah. He might come back.
They are level 1 health. Oh,
look at that low.
1B. The range on this move.
Wow.
Oh, and the lethal is 6-8. If you get caught. And when she's in Soul Charge, she's even more damaged. And gets hit by the unblockable!
Oh god.
Oh, this might be death! No, oh, just out of range!
Oh, this is ugly.
No, Jolz does still have two bars.
Do you think he can bring it back here?
Absolutely.
No.
I take it back.
This is a madness. Hey, listen, everyone in the Twitch chat, your channel points are there. Use them, because this might be, we might have to do a first to 10 at some point next week, you know?
I think that's what it's going to have to be. If Kaz keeps up this momentum and he beats him 3-0 here, we're going to have to do a run back.
Absolutely, but you know, we saw the situation before. Where Kaz was up 1, then up 2, and then just like that in the blink of an eye, Jolz adapted.
Bruh, this is looking really, really convincing right now, I'm not going to lie, but you know what? Masop did start strong in the last one, so I don't really know when it. This is looking.
Yeah, Jolz was very good at adapting, so we can't count him out just yet. I mean, that did look extremely one-sided, and it started off well for Talon again, but we can't count him out just based on what we saw in the last set.
Well, and here come the mix-ups. Absolutely disgusting character with so many options for the Vortex.
That life.
Ooh.
Oh, we got the Lion King carry. The range, and here come the A. No, doesn't finish the screen.
God.
Oh, wow.
And you guys saw the life lead. You saw the.
Wow.
Melted.
Okay, so that could shake anyone's confidence. You know, to be one hit away, and then you just get it stolen from you like that.
Welcome to the new age of fighting games, man.
This is gonna. Oh, it didn't fall for the tech trap. Break apart with the spine buster. Now, you know, the three main moves that Mina has, 6-6-A, 6-A, and 1-B, all become so much more. But that doesn't mean a single thing to Jolz. He's just going to push through.
Man, the group chat's going to be on fire this weekend, bro.
Several group chats are going to be on fire.
Ooh, yeah.
Group tech. Oh, we got horizontal problems, yeah. Where verticals apparently don't work.
Nice break.
Oh, get him the lethal hit. Body splash.
So it looks like we're looking at a 1-1 situation right now. So Jolz proving that he has adapted to the general style of Talon. But Talon's trying to bring it back here.
Oh, Jolz needs. Oh no! Get him with the 1B, but he's still locked and stuck. 2 bars a meter, and we've seen the amount of damage that Astaroth can do with these bars.
So is Song Mina generally got the most range in this game or something?
Potentially, yes. She has a lot. I mean, you've seen the amount of range that B has, and this is like nearly full screen. Oh, good sidestep into Soul Charge. Gets hit by the Beyblade. Is this guaranteed? No, doesn't fall for the tech trap.
Nice. Can he bring it back?
Can he go for the unblockable? No, go for the guaranteed.
And his health just hit. What the hell? That's it. Oh,
not quite. One more confirm. And the back 10 B+ game.
He's still in the fight. I gotta say, Astaroth looks really weird right now. Did he lose his boots or something?
He did. Yeah, it kind of looked like Gigas.
He looks like Johnny Bravo.
Oh, doesn't fall for the 4-4-A tech trap. This is something that used to plague everyone in Season 1. You're open. Oh, gets him with the armored.
Oh, no.
He's dead.
That's it. That's it. We're looking at 1-1 right now.
Oh, wow. Oh, no.
Joel just in his head right now. Grab after grab after grab, conditioning Kaz, and Kaz just doesn't know what to do except Soul Charge and try and run Mina's game as best as he.
I'm here.
This is a bit of a confidence shake because now his character's getting shaven off one at a time. Does he have any other characters in his arsenal if he is to drop this set?
He does have a Hilda. Well, I say he has a Hilda. What I mean is he.
My Hilda was smashed, mate.
To be? Your Hilda can barely come back my fucking 2B. Get out of here.
Oh man.
Hilda, best character in the game, and you can't beat my goddamn fucking nightmare.
Damn. Shots fired. This might be another. We might have to do a grudge match on fighting games on a Saturday. I feel like it's.
You can't be saying them things without backing it up, dude.
Yeah.
Dude, we had games like.
It was
50 to like 10.
I did not press.
But you got to prove it to the stream.
Ooh, dude, I will get up the screenshot. 50 to 10.
Can I just ask a question? Why does she have these green white socks and? Anyways, back to the game, man.
That's just Kaz's weird taste in customization.
Oh my god.
He's potentially revealing a fetish here that maybe he didn't want people to know about.
Oh, is he making it? Ooh! No, it nice. Is.
Oh, that's nasty. That range is disgusting, man. She just catch you at any part of the stage.
And what makes it even worse is that Mina has one of the better steps in the game. And this goes hand in hand with how good her 2-2-B is.
God, that little string there, it just looks so irritating to deal with.
It is! It's a safe jailing niche, and it has such confidence as well. But meanwhile, Kaz doing exceptionally well in this game, being up 2 rounds.
Yeah, he definitely looks like this would have been better to run in the first 10, but then Joel could very easily adapt in the coming games and just completely show him up again.
We'll get him with the bull rush twice. Plus frames. Kaz doesn't press, but gets spine busted.
Kaz is he's been a lot more patient right now, which I'm not really used to seeing from him.
I mean, with Mina, you are kind of allowed. Oh no, that's not gonna work! Oh, it is gonna work, I apologize.
That's what you get when you make everything a one button super. Everything is reactable.
Plus frames. Oh, calls out the AGI! Against the edge, this is not where you want to be. Good back step. Good punish. No, doesn't get the full conversion.
And they're dangerously close to the edge right now, and he pops the soul charge.
You know what's gonna happen now. And there's the bull rush.
Plus eight.
What's the mix, guys? What's the mix?
I got him back to man.
You got him back to too early.
I'm really gonna look forward to hearing what they have to say after this.
The group chat. I'm just saying the group chat every time, bro. The group chat.
Yeah, let me just open my phone and see what the group chat is saying right now, because I can bet you any money it's ugly.
Let me turn the TV on. Hold on. Let me turn the TV on.
Boy, I've got a couple missed calls, that's all I'll say.
Yeah. This is rough.
And Dolph potentially 3 games away from him.
Kaz has really got to do something here, man. Because the any potential for a run back is being taken away here.
Another spine buster and the ball rush ring out.
You hate to
Dolph 2 games away.
This is very bad, you know.
I think his composure's been shaken. I mean, this is pretty much undeniable at this point.
Gets him with the Terra Moon! Good sidestep, 2-2-B.
Punishing him to perfection right now.
Joel's decision making is absolutely spot on right now. Breaking all the throws. Didn't break that throw, though.
Just break again. Nice. Looking for a ring out.
2-2-A and gets him with 1 game! Oh, once again on match point.
Oh no.
Not like this, guys! Not like this!
Hey, you lot, share your energy, man, please, in the chat. Share it.
Oh, boy, talent, man. He's absolutely mollywatch right here.
Oh, man.
This is looking like a Vegeta beatdown, man. You know, he talks too much and he becomes an antagonist. Oh,
the ones where Goku needs to save him.
He got the powers of a god of destruction, and it still wasn't enough for Vegeta. Spoilers, guys. And that's it. Not quite. No, one more confirm.
He has to do something.
Plus eight. And Kaz could still bring this back. One more 1B, and that's it.
Hey, he's not out yet. Excellent help.
That was a comeback still.
Hanging on for his dear life. Gets him with a low throw, good break! Good whip punish, what's the mix? No, up for the damage ender!
Okay, he's rushing that, he does not wanna. He's not out of fight yet. He could very easily bring this back and it will change the entire
time. Oh, that's. No, he dropped the combo!
Oh no!
I come back to buy him in here!
Ooh! Ooh! Ooh!
Ooh! Ooh! Guys,
Talon, please do something!
Bro, please!
Locked up for the 16.
Oh no!
One's even going with it! No, after so much!
No!
Just hit him once!
Oh, that's it! He's gone! He's hit!
Oh, man, that is a heartbreaker!
No!
He just hit him with a leg lift! You just see him just chucking his leg lift!
Man, I need to kill this, man, I'm saying!
There's no lag, man.
Let's just do one. Just one match. I want to see how he does. Let's do one match with Hilda. I just want to see Sam. Can you hear me?
Hilda must be good against Sansa.
Well, let's try it. I just want to see Sam.
So you agree that you've lost that set as well, yeah?
No, to be honest, no, I don't agree with that because I ain't been using Sangmina for months, innit?
Oh, alright, cool. Use it on.
Cassandra versus, Sangmina versus whoever he wants, but I need like a week to warm up in it.
Alright, so Hilda versus Ashraf then, now.
No one forced you to pick Cassandra, yeah? And you had way, you had 2 weeks.
To be honest, I didn't need my best to beat you in it. That's what it was.
The problem is that you're so shit. What's this up to?
You're playing RuneScape. I'm playing 3D chess. You see what I'm saying? So that's the problem.
He's playing a different game. That's what I mean. What's this up to you?
First to one,
I guess.
Okay. Oh, bro. I hope you win, bro.
So Hilda demolishes every character in the game. It's unequivocally tough.
What is that move?
3K. It is so disgusting, and it's one of the best step killers in the game.
That is stupid. That looks so serious.
The main matter is worse, right? When she has like a sword regalia, it becomes the best I-14 punish in the game.
Is this Kaz's best character then?
It's the best character. I don't think it's Kaz's best character.
Kaz is cheap, you know. He is cheap.
Absolutely. You know, when you play a game like this, you have to play what's right. You have to play what's cheap.
But we can't do first to one here. We got to do at least a first to three. Because if Kaz wins this,
he's just getting a lucky bonus win, isn't it? Yeah. Oh, he's not gonna. Okay.
I'll make sure.
Don't tech. Oh, it takes out the tech trap.
Hey, nah, you know, this has to be a running thing on the channel. I think I'm gonna start doing different games, grudge matches, because this is hilarious.
Yeah, you got it, man.
Oh my god.
I never use Switch, but I have to use it against him because I don't know what he's gonna do.
Yo, Jay, have you seen the new Demon Slayer fighting game?
Yeah, do you play that?
Yeah, I play it, yeah.
Bro, grudge match. We have to get someone on, bro. We'll get someone on. Yeah. Oh, snap.
That's not gonna work. It is gonna work. So the raw damage on this isn't too hot.
She shank him in his junk.
Yes.
That's what I was just thinking. Yeah.
But no,
that's something she does to everyone. Or is it because he's
not yet?
Oh no! What is happening?
That's a classic. What's his name again? That wrestler. He says, "I don't even know if that's PG." That's a classic moment.
Yeah.
True. Yeah.
Oh you hate to see it.
Dead, no! Dead, got dead, caught by dead, the arm dead. And it's not dead yet. But what?
Mix up. Yeah.
One more. Is there any point in doing more games or?
Just one more.
Yeah, you know, just give him one more. Yeah, just give him
one more.
Last one. Give him one more, man.
That was bullshit, man.
The boy goes deeper, the worse it's gonna be. That's the way I'm looking at it, because it's even gonna get worse. Let's ask him for one more and gonna lose again. That's gonna be mad.
He's using different characters. He's gonna say, let me try this guy one.
I mean, Joe's made a statement.
No.
Yes.
I'm done.
We've gone past Perfect Legend.
We're gonna come back with another first to 10, don't worry.
We've gone past Perfect Legend.
I don't see anything.
Oh, man.
He won the first to 10, he won the first to 3, he's won the first to 2.
Oh, man.
Kaz, you gotta do something here, bro. You have got to do something here. Everyone's rooting for you.
In the stream chat, let me know if you want to see this regular, like, you know, grudge matches on different fighting games. Press 1 in the chat if you want to see that, man. I'll make it happen. Commentators, all of that stuff.
I'm pressing one. I want to see more of this.
This.
Oh no, what's the mix? Go for the 1K!
Yeah, Josh is comfortable here. He's not even, it doesn't seem like he's trying. He's in.
Bro, he's getting out there. He's doing road grabs and the man is standing. He's not respecting it.
You know what? We need to get the Duffin games. I want to see Demon Slayer. Demon Slayer is one of them ones that I've watched, but I haven't seen anyone play competitive or anything like that, or trash talking.
Yeah, it's got a decent scene. Obviously, it's kind of separate from the other like classic FGCs, but fighting games. But I think the Naruto community really transferred over to it.
Yeah, because it looks like that kind of like the old school PS2. Is it PS2 ones? The ones where they kind of got that kind of running one where you could run up. Yeah. Ultimate Ninja.
Yeah, Ultimate Ninja Storm on PS3 and PS4. I think it came out.
Right. Exactly. Yeah, now I want to see that, man, because I don't want it to just be the A tier fighting games. I want it to be other games as well, man.
Yeah, man, definitely.
This is done.
No, that's not.
Is that gonna take?
I think that's death.
Ooh!
In the junk.
I don't even know if that's PG.
Yeah, that is mad.
That looks mad. That looks so mad.
That is mad.
I don't know, bro. You know the early stages where they were doing that creating thing and people are doing that stuff with the characters.
The Warriors, bro, it's just insane.
Bro, that's what I'm saying. I don't know. I wouldn't put it past them if they knew already.
I mean, when they announced Hilda and they showed it, it was like one of the main yes, Hilda does stab you with the gun.
You know what? We might have to set this one up again for a first to 10 later on down the line. I don't know though, it's only first to 1 in it though, so I don't know, but it's looking a bit more convincing.
Well, I mean, Joe's already taken the first game. If he takes this one, then it's pretty much dead in the water.
Look at the damage, man! Yes, it is! One more mix of Joe! Is he gonna do the throw? He
faded
him! No,
he
didn't!
Oh, he pressed the button. And he got him in the junk again!
Go for the left nut, go for the right nut.
Nice.
That's a wrap.
That's cool. Don't worry, man. That is a fact statement.
Like, there is no doubt now. Joe is the dominant player.
One day you get to play my main, one day.
Yeah?
Oh, no.
I think now you won't. I like that.
Oh no!
That was good. But I was focusing on Cassandra, so I need time to warm up with the others. So don't worry, we're coming back with a first of 10. We'll do Sangmina. Sangmina versus whoever. I'm gonna fuck him up, man. Don't worry.
to spice things up, guys. Would you guys be willing to bet something in your next grudge match?
Yeah, I would actually. Hell yeah.
Online betting. I don't wanna. What do you wanna bet? I've already taken his soul, what else can I take?
took his soul, took his mother, stole his nachos!
Oh no, man. Yeah, it's a bit of a silent one, man. What happened, man?
I'm on it, mate, don't worry. We'll bring it back, don't worry.
And you know what? Whatever other game you play, Joel, if you play Street Fighter, Tekken, I'll smack you on that as well.
No, no, we're gonna keep it on Soul Calibur because this is like a serious, like, I've been seeing the back and forth with you lot a lot. I haven't, might not have said anything, but I'm just looking like, oh,
I
damn.
Reckon I could beat you at Tekken as well, to be honest, and Street Fighter.
Oh,
I'm not even mad at you. Right. I didn't play them and I'll still be able to beat you.
Oh, oh no.
I do remember that Joel entered Street Fighter. What was it? Versus Fighting, and he got a perfect on Bang Chan.
What did you just say? It cut off.
Oh damn!
So he's got a perfect on Bonchan and Street Fighter 5.
No, no, I beat him 3 perfects in a row. I don't know. I don't know if this guy's joking or not, but I never played him. I played him at EGX. Yeah.
Huh.
And yeah. I took a round of him.
Yeah, he took a round of Bonchan. So, you know, no, I'd be fucking scared.
So obviously. We've done this grudge match, you know. Obviously, I know that Joel's main character is not Astroff. Is that correct? Am I correct?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, Serbian and Secret.
Yeah, so obviously, this was basically just to prove that he can beat him with the character. Now, obviously, we put that story to bed. And obviously, like I said, I do feel like we need to run it back again. But I feel like we need to run it back but with the main characters, you know. Plug your Mixbox in, Joel. Get Siegfried or Cervantes in. Kasim, you need to probably get like, I don't know, you got loads of characters that you play. But, you know, get a character in. And I feel like we should lock another one in for next week.
I'm on it, 100%.
We're going to do first to 10. Mm. But obviously, Hollow and Zero, you okay for next week?
I should be, yeah.
Yeah, what time are you thinking?
Same time?
We could do same time. We could do the same time, or we could schedule it in the group chat. Of course, we'd have to be put on the spot.
A little bit earlier because I've got to go to Cambridge in the evening. So, by this time, I'd already be on the train.
Yeah,
so if we could a little bit earlier, I'll 100% be done for that.
All right, wicked, cool. So, that story of what's got happening today has been put to bed. It's a tough one. It's a tough one. It was very, very one-sided, to say the least. But we're going to get another one going on again. We're also going to add other games. Like, I didn't think this was going to be so entertaining. I'm sitting back here watching this happen. And I'm like, nah, this is really entertaining. So we are probably going to get another game on. We could probably get like something like Tekken or Street Fighter, Demon Slayer, Melty Blood, even Unist, whatever. We'll figure out what games we're gonna do, and we're just gonna probably make it like 2 games that we'll do every Saturday and Sunday. It'll probably just be like, I don't know, grudge match weekends or something. I don't know, but we're gonna get something going on and make it fun. So yeah, man. Shout out to the players. Shout out to the commentators. Zero, Hollow. Shout out to the guy that lost a lot, Kasim. I'm sorry, man. Shout out to Silent Joe as well for the, you know, for the Astral beatdown.
F's in chat for
Oh man, alright, cool. Well, I guess that is a wrap for everyone. I appreciate everyone tuning in. I'm gonna sign out. I'll probably play later on a bit of Tekken and probably some other games as well. But yeah, I hope you lot enjoyed that, and yeah, we'll be making this a thing on the weekends, man. So yeah, hope